Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we are going to look at the second part of this tutorial, where I'm fine-tuning a ViT classifier and personalized with my own data. In the previous tutorial we looked at how to build the datasets for training the model, and today we are going to see essentially the training and fine-tuning the model. So let's start. Now we are using a GPU instance in Google Colab. I'm using a T4 16 GB GPU. It's not very expensive. You can see here 2.05 credits per hour, and well, the processes take around about 3.5 hours, depending on the size of your batch and also the size of how many steps you choose to do the validation step. So we set up, we install the library you need, we connect to our drive, we log in 1DB. We create our dictionary for transforming categories to labels. We load the classes, the libraries we need. We create the class labels. We load the datasets from this. If you look, you watch the part one of this tutorial, you see how we serialize the datasets into arrow files to the local disks, to Google Drive in this case. We create the dataset dictionary, in case that you finally want to push the dataset to Hugging Face. I didn't do it due to the specific material that we are working on. We had some pictures that are not advisable to upload there, and we have here the pictures, the features of the train data set. Just we are checking that everything is exactly the same as we leave it on the first part of this tutorial. The image 400, that is a drawing. The image size, you have it here as well. On this is image is a pillow object. The labels, so the features, the feature labels in your train dataset, and here this helper function that transform integers into categories. So we are using a vision transformer. It's a modality designed to work with the computer vision with images, and it's pretty similar to a conventional transformer. And you can see here essentially the concept. You just take an image, you just split the image from left to right, from top down, and just you prepare a long vector and input the transformer encoder. No? You have the full documentation of the ViT, the Vision Transformer, in this link, and you can go through and read the paper. It's quite interesting. I highly recommend you to do that. No? We use as a pre-trained model from Google with this architecture. We are using here this class is the image processor. Is doing some transformation. We create and we will go through now. We use this class as a feature extractor. We load the model from Hugging Face. A recommendation: if you work with Google Colab, and you may know that you need a secret to access to the API, you just can keep it here. The name is hf_token, and then if you have it like this with your token, read write permissions, you don't need to put the token every time that you connect to Hugging Face. So here the parameters that this model, this class, sorry, the ViT image processor, we just look, the by default the model is doing normalization, rescale, and resize. We had we use a 0.5 as mean for every channel, a 0.5 as a standard deviation, a resample category 2, which is, I don't remember what is, bilineal resample, a factor of 0.004, and the size of the image to input the model is 224 by 224. We are just going to plot an image after passing through the feature extractor. You see here, after passing the image through the feature extractor, you get a dictionary with a just single key, pixel values, with a set of 3 channels, 244 by 244. This is exactly what is happening here. Just to give you an insight here, you can decide not to normalize or not to rescale or resize, and choose a different values for mean and standard deviation, and also some other algorithm to resample and another rescale factor. It's up to you, but probably there is something for my project is good enough, these values I didn't change it. So we just take the image and we just plot it. We are transforming the tensor, PyTorch tensor, to NumPy, and we plot it. As you can see, the image is similar to the original image, but obviously after passing through the feature extractor, it had a different size, and we are normalizing the image with some values, so it's slightly different, but well, it's keeping the content, no, and the mean of the image, no? It's just a pre-processing for imputing the final classifier. Here we create some helper functions. Just we are adding another key to the dictionary, and here we just transform the whole dataset. DS, if you remember here, DS is the dataset dictionary object with the 3 datasets, train, validation, and test. We transform the whole dataset here, and you just look at one example, is pixels and labels. It's just creating a single dictionary. Now we create this function. This is used on training the data collator. This function is just simply unpacking the dictionary we created before. It's just something that we need for the object trainer, the PyTorch Lightning object trainer. And then here we define the metric. We use accuracy, as I mentioned before. The dataset is correctly balanced. We don't need to do anything like weighting classes, something like that. We had same number of pictures per class in the different data sets, and as I mentioned as well, probably there is some quality issues, but well, it's not affecting really to the performance of the model and during the training. Maybe you had another requirement, just to use F1 or rock. You can decide to use another metric. It's up to you, and depending on the requirement of your project. Here we look at the length of the features. Here we are creating 2 dictionaries. One is to transform integers into categories, and the other to do the opposite the job, no, categories to labels. Those 2 are used on the ViT for image classification class. This is the classifier. Essentially, we just take the same model and we plug into the head a classifier, a linear classifier, and then it's using as parameter number of labels and these 2 dictionaries to as a helpers. We define the model is just downloading the model from Hugging Face, and then here is really detecting that the model originally was classified by for 21,000 classes. So yes, you here pass different labels. He is already realizing that you are going to pre-train the, so to fine-tune the model. Here we clean our GPU. Here we are defining the training arguments for the training, conventional parameters, output this where we keep the checkpoints, 16 images per watt, per device. In this case, as we just had one GPU, we are not using data parallelization, but the watt size is 16. You can choose as well a different a watt size for the evaluation phase. By default is 16 as well, if I don't remember wrong, but you can choose another one just if you have that requirement and you think that it's going to improve the performance. Now, evaluation strategies per step. This means that the number of steps that we define here, at 500 steps we will do an evaluation of the we will do a evaluation step, and it's done every in my case every 500 steps. We run 20 epochs. This means that we will go through the whole training dataset 20 times. We are using floating points, 16 bits. We reduce the precision. The model originally was fine-tuned by Google with this precision. We keep the precision. This is a technique with name quantization. We will have a tutorial as well for that. It's just to reduce the memory footprint of your model. Learning rate 1 to the minus 4 is just a starting learning rate. We set a total of the two best checkpoints. We remove unnecessary columns. Here we are going to remove the paths because we don't use it on the training phase. We don't push the model to Hugging Face. We keep it local. We report all the activity to 1 dB to weight and bias, and at the end of the model at the end of the process we load the best model, the best checkpoint into memory. Here we define the trainer object model. This is the foundation model, the arguments that we defined in the previous cell, the data collation, the function to we define here. Just to unpack the dictionary, the metrics, train dataset, evaluation dataset, and the feature extractor. And here we just start the training. It's gonna take 3 hours. We introduce it everything in a with sentence that we are going to lock everything to 1 dB. It's a job type training, and then let's have an example. It's gonna take again 3 hours. I will be back when we run two or three evaluation phases just to see how it looks like, and then we will continue with the tutorial. See you. Hi, welcome back. We already had three iterations of the validation check after 1,500 steps. As you can see, the performance of the model is going very well. We are already hitting 91% accuracy. The process, as I said, is going to take around about three hours. We will continue with a previous version of the same notebook, where I had already done for experiments with this fine tuning, you can go through here. It's exactly the same, doing evaluation every 500 steps. So just simply finish the process. We hit 93%. As you can see here, the history. This is produced by the trainer. The summary. We are simply here. I take the status, the state of the training, and I serialize to the JSON file in order to produce some plots. I create a dataset with the state, loss, and accuracy just to do some plots. Get the maximum and minimum accuracy, 93 and 26. Here you have a plot of the accuracy, a plot of the loss. Here just simply printing the metrics of the trainer, and here we are updating uploading the dataset to 1DB. Here we run an evaluation with the test dataset. We are hitting 92 practically, meaning that we are not overfitting. We just print the metrics here of the evaluation process, and here we are taking the best model, as I mentioned before. In there is a parameter here on the lot best model at the end true. This means that the best model, either the best model or the latest model, will be pointing to the best model or the best checkpoint or your training process. I just save the model to local, and here I load the model to 1DB for versioning. If we go to 1DB, let's take a look at the runs. You can see here, for example, this is a training process, so you can see here how the model was performing, system statistics as well. If you go to artifacts, you can see different versions of the model that we are training. We already train and push to 1DB 4 versions. Here you have the history of every run. You have here the table that we are producing. This table is just something like that. Step is a pandas data frame with the outcomes. Here you can compare all the experiments that you made. Yeah, a good tool. I recommend you, highly recommend you. It's for ML engineers or data scientists which had experience with ML flow. They will find it very convenient, but well, it's up to you. Okay, we finish here the this part two. Later we will speak about inference with the images and video, and hope you meet you there. You like the content, please give me a like and subscribe if you didn't do it before. Ciao.